Hello there. Hello there. And one more time. Hello there. Oh, that's a bit better, isn't it? It's Mike here, One Go Short Play. Sorry about that. I was just having a little mess with my microphone. I haven't used this for a couple of weeks. I haven't played any Mega Drive for a couple of weeks. Welcome back to One Go Short Play. I've been away for... The Christmas holidays have just ended. You may have noticed I haven't uploaded any videos for a couple of weeks. That's why. But usually I kind of stockpile a big batch of these videos and you know, upload them as I go along. Usually as time permits and whenever I'm working at home, if I get a kind of a... I usually get a bit of a break every now and then and I'll upload a video. I haven't done it for a few weeks. So I'm totally out of practice and my microphone's all over the place and I'm sure everything is all over the place. So I do apologise if this video sounds rubbish. It might sound great, who knows. Let's see. Bubble and Squeak for the Sega Mega Drive or Genesis, depending on where you're from. Never played this one, seen it. It's about a little boy and his pet thing, isn't it? Whatever that thing is that's bigger than him. I might have played this before, actually. It's one of those games, isn't it, where... Oh, that's very reminiscent of Krusty's Funhouse, that later part of that jump. I've just noticed that. I believe it's one of those games where... Oh, scary. Where two characters... Oh, that didn't work, did it? Two characters... not so much interact, but share a level. Oh, scary. And as a result, sorry, I'm playing and thinking at the same time, or talking even, share a level, and one of them has certain skills and the other one has certain other skills. That can't be good. Where's my little timer that tells me I'm about to die? Anyone? Can we see it? No. Oh wow, it didn't so much warn me as just, wow, kill me. That was impressive. Did I miss something there? I was just testing it, looking for something to go red and flash, or, you know, something like that. This looks very like Krusty's Funhouse in a weird way. All right, got those Mario-style hills in the background. Also a little bit Alfred Chicken-y. But there's something about the way he jumps. It's that jump. And these little background pieces like that there, it reminds me of Krusty's Funhouse. Now, when I was a kid, I play-tested Krusty's Funhouse. I think it was a port. Was it a port? Oh, no, I'm actually stuck. Oh, that's not good. Oh, thank goodness for that. That's better. It was a port of it. I can't remember if it was to the SNES or from the SNES. I have a feeling it was from the SNES. Oh, no, actually, it might be to the SNES. I can't remember. It was a port of Krusty's Funhouse. So someone else had made the original game and the company I worked with did the port. I think that's right. They might have actually done the original for all I know. I was 14 or 15 and... Oh, yeah, I can shoot. Oh, that's very thingy arrow. The acrobat, isn't it? Have I got limited stars? Possibly. It was a very good game. Although, it was a little too cerebral for my liking then. I was into kind of action platformers. And Krusty's Funhouse was a very thinking platformer. In which... You had to go wandering about and figure out how to set traps for mice, and that was, or rats, or whatever they were. And that was good. The game was very good. It was very solid. This is very good and very solid. But again, it's not very action-y. More action-y than Krusty's Funhouse, because that. But, actually, I think Krusty's Funhouse had stars as well. On a limited basis. But, yes. Cerebral, but a bit of thinking there. See me do a bit of thinking. Ah, now this is familiar. Oh, look, I'm literally twiddling his thumbs. Oh, baseball bat is it? Oh no, he actually got me. That was some dodgy collision detection right there. Oh, I like the way he's like twiddling his thumbs and feeling a bit lonely. And along I come, I stand on his head and die. Cool. Well, now we know we can shoot stars. That's good. We're in a good place. Let's shoot some stars. It was a good game, Krusty's Funhouse. This feels like it a lot, and I can't put my finger on why, as you may have noticed. I don't know why I'm doing all this again. Should we just progress? Let's progress. Ignore the diamonds. I didn't even see them coming then. You may or may not notice, I have a cold. I'm doing an awful lot of mouth breathing because my nose is a bit of a mess. Well, not a mess, it's just really, really blocked. And it's doing my head in because I haven't had a cold for ages, and I was getting to the point where I was like, yes, I can weather the cold and don't get colds and stuff. And I've got one. Well, I think I have. Which is really annoying because I was meant to be in work today, the work that I go to work, as opposed to the other part-time job I do where I work at home. That work, oh, he actually shot something at me. But yeah, that work is closed today for a training day for some of the other staff. So, oh, he hit it back at me. Oh, and killed me. Why did I do that? Why did I ask for that a second time? Go on again. Yeah, so I've been doing my work for them from home, and now I'm having a little break because I've been working very hard today. And I'm going to do a couple of videos and put them up. Or at least do one and put it up. what was I on about? I can't remember. It's actually gone. I've drawn a blank. Never mind. But yeah, that's it. Cold. On the day I'm due to go back, and I don't actually have to because I can do it from home, I would go and catch a cold, wouldn't I? That was it. That was my point. I'm back on track. The train has landed, re-landed on the thought track. The track of thought. Or something like that. I like the artwork of those little diamonds. They're quite pretty. Diamonds are always tricky to draw. There's a technique to it. But they're nice. I like them. I don't know why I'm collecting them all again. I like those big fat coins as well, they're cool. I like, you know, the ease of death for most baddies. I don't like those little baseball baddies. They're going to be, them and I are going to be mortal enemies, I feel. Come on, there he is. So he didn't hit me. He hit my star at me. And that hit me. Yes. Down you go, my friend. Down you go. So it looks like all the Squeak, I'm guessing his name is, if this is Bubble, C button is a follow me button, C button, follow me button, oh no, don't do that, oh I'm such an idiot, right, see this is annoying, there's not much action in waiting for that baddie to walk past you so you can hit him, I know, it's a limited AI, and it works in my favour ultimately, but it's a bit slow. Oh, what? A bit slow. And that did not work in my favour. Die. I don't like these ducks. The crap. Not only are they crap, but the crap and they kill you. But I mean, the crap in that they kill you, but they're also crap in that they're... Oh, no, he shot me. You know, a baddie that's got the intelligence to hit something back at you should probably also have the intelligence to be able to see you and to come at you. I don't know, it jars on me that he can hit stuff at me but can't see me, you know? He sees me stars but doesn't see me. What's that about? It doesn't make sense. It doesn't feel right. I'm bigger than me stars. He's an antagonist. He should be antagonizing. I don't know what I'm talking about. But you might know. You might get the gist of what I'm trying to say. It's the first video back for weeks. What can I say? I'm drawing a lot of blanks. Although I am quite, it's mainly because I'm quite enjoying this game. It's very, very solid the way it's put together. And it's very good fun. Actually, speaking of solid, while I was off for Christmas, despite having a baby and stupidly agreeing to go on all the, the Christmas visits and not making them come to us, which we really should have done and we will certainly do next year, we're knackered. But I somehow managed to find a bit of time to make a little demo of a platform game based on my cat Ginny, or as we sometimes call her, Smut Smut, on account of her spitting a lot when she was a kitten. And I made a little platformer that's nice and solid. Very, very basic graphics, of course. I think I've got to use Squeak somehow. But yeah, it's brill. I really like it. And I think I might have a... I've been playing with Construct 2. I think I might have a further play with Construct 2. Ow. And it got me thinking of an idea for the channel. But I tell you what, this video's over. So I'll tell you that in the next one. And I've just died. Flipping heck. That was Bubble and Squeak for the Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.